At this point, the basic assembly of your owl box is complete. What we have to do to finish it up is to take the roof off and to apply some silicone sealant. And then we'll drill some holes in the top and bottom for mounting. An optional 3/8 inch drill bit. This is used for drilling the mounting hole. For the upper mounting holes, we're going to make three marks. One at 3 inches from each edge. One approximately 4.5 inches, about in the middle. These should be approximately 1 inch from the end. These are the mounting holes, so they aren't real critical, but consistency is also nice. So we have marking here at 3 inches from this side, 3 inches this side, and one in the middle. Now we're going to use our 1/8 inch bit, which we haven't used until now, to make the holes on the two sides. Now we've drilled these holes so that they could hold 3-inch long screws, which would be used to fasten this to the tree, or you can use aluminum nails. For our production models, we drill a 3/8 inch or larger hole in the center. The reason we do this is so that you could pass a rope, such as a clothesline, through it to make hoisting the unit into the air, into the tree, easier. Now I've rotated the unit so we have the bottom part. And again, we'll make a mark around 3 inches from each side and about 1 inch or so up. These will be our lower mounting points. And again, taking our 1/8 inch bit, we're going to drill out these holes. There are the two lower mounting points. Now you're probably wondering, when the heck am I going to apply the silicone to the roof? Well, there's a reason why I've delayed. It's because you can't paint over silicone. You can't stain over silicone. It'll screw up your work. So what you need to do before you do any of that is that the unit has to be either stained or painted first. So, stain or paint your owl box first. Once it is completely dried, you'll apply the silicone. So let's assume that this has already been stained. Here's how you'd put the silicone on. You would remove the roof by backing out the four mounting screws. Next, you would lay a bead of silicone across this top edge here on the left side. You lay a bead on this top edge here on the right side. And finally, lay a bead across where the roof meets. Once those three beads of silicone are in place, carefully lay the roof back into place and refasten. If any silicone squeezes out along the edge, just use your finger to smooth it out. Again, do this after you have stained or painted. As a final touch, lay a bead of silicone across the top where the top and the back meet. Give it a good amount, lay it in place, and then use your finger to to smooth it out. It should look like a nice caulk bead you'd see in your bathroom. Also apply a little extra around any gaps around the roof, such as this edge here. And that's it for the basic assembly of your Screech Owl box. The only thing remaining would be to stain it. Remember, stain first, then silicone. Silicone would be the absolute last thing that you do. Then you hang it in the tree. I'm not going to go into any great detail about staining this unit because there are plenty of articles out there on how to apply stain. We happen to use a weatherproofing sealant. It's a toner. It's oil-based. It's available in a variety of colors. I would recommend either a redwood color or their canyon brown. All of our production units are canyon brown, which is a dark brown color. Before you stain, you could always sand the unit. You can get rid of the lumber marks, but it's not really a big deal. This unit is going to be up in a tree, needs to be kind of camouflaged to begin with, so these sorts of things are not even going to be visible. But if you want to have it nice, you can certainly sand it down before you apply your oil-based stain. Now, some people have expressed concern about using a stain on these sorts of boxes, being afraid that the animals won't like it. Now, recall that most stains are oil-based, and the oil that they use is linseed oil. Linseed oil is often used as a food additive for chickens, for example. The bigger thing that we've found is that the animals are more afraid of the human scent and, quite frankly, some of the scent of the toner itself. So once you've completed your unit, get it outside as soon as possible so that you can get out in the air, get the human scents off of it, and let any toner scent evaporate. Your other option, instead of using such a light colored pine such as this, would be to use a redwood or a cedar. The challenge with using cedar is that in these dimensions, it's very expensive. If you price out a 1x10 piece of cedar 8 feet long, it's anywhere from $20 to $25 from what we've seen in a planed, nice, workable piece of cedar. That would make this owl box in lumber alone cost over $50, not including the fasteners, the silicone, and everything else. Instead, we've opted to go with the plain, easily available white pine. It's easy to work with. It takes the stain very, very well. You can also, if you're concerned about the stain, you can think of other ways to stain the unit. The key is you want it to look like it belongs in a tree. Perhaps that means some gray and some black spray paint. That might work. Or perhaps you're able to get a hold of some good used lumber. The older lumber is going to be seasoned, but it's also going to be harder to work with. It's going to be more liable to split. It's not going to be as clean. It may be warped. But use your imagination. Now you know how the basic assembly goes. You could do whatever you want. And plus, once you've made the full-size version, now you can play around a bit and make a model, such as the one that I've made here. We hope that you've enjoyed our video and found it educational. If you have any questions or comments, please leave either a YouTube comment or send us an email at support@kontore.net. That's KONTORE.net. support@kontore.net.